Verse 14. According to the scriptures, he said to the heavens, he sits there and as saw that he's coming again as glory, he said, the living and dead, the kingdom shall be on, yes, we in the Holy Spirit. We proceed from the Father, who the Father and Son worship and glorified, and spoke by the prophets and on the Holy Catholic Apostolic Church. We confess on baptism for the remission of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and life of the age to come. Amen.
We ask you, the Lamb of God, the meek, who takes away the sins of the whole world, to hear us, have mercy on us, and forgive us our sins. Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Amen.
مبشير ينبر نفمعي ثقوات ونوطي الأمور في زمارة وتنجي فنوطي فيوت في بانتوكراتور
آمين
في زمارة وتنجي فمون جميس نشير يسوس بإخلستوس بن شويس
آمين
في زمارة وتنجي بنفمعي ثقوات من باراكليتور
yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
Pray that God may have mercy and compassion on us, hear us, help us, and accept the supplication and prayers of His saints, for Thou which is good and our behalf at all times, and to keep the life and standing of our honored Father, Thy priest, Pope Theodosius II, and his partner in the Apostolic Liturgy, our Bishop Alba Yusuf, and make us worthy to partake of the communion of His holy and blessed mysteries for the remission of our sins.
Therefore, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind, grant us to complete this holy day and all the days of our life in all peace with your fear, all envy, all temptation, all the will of Satan, the counsel of wicked men, and the rising up of enemies hidden and manifest, take them away from us. And from all your people, and from this table, and from this your holy place. But those things which are good and profitable do provide for us,
For it is you who have given all the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and upon all the power of the enemy.
Oh. Because he could swear by no one greater, he swore by himself, saying, Surely blessing I will bless you, and multiplying I will multiply you. And so, after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. The grace of the God his Father be with you all.
Catholic epistle from the first epistle that teaches St. Jude is blessed to be upon you, men, my beloved. Now Enoch, the seventh from Adam, prophesies about these men, also saying, Behold, the Lord comes with 10,000 of his saints to execute judgment on all, to convict all who are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have committed in an ungodly way, and all of the harsh things which ungodly sinners have spoken against them. These are murmurers, complainers, walking according to their own lusts, and they mouth great swelling words, flattering people to gain advantage. But you, beloved, remember the words which were spoken before by the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, how they told you that there would be mockers in the last time who would walk according to their own ungodly lusts. These are sensual persons, who cause divisions not having the Spirit. But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit, keeping yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life, and on the same and on some have compassion, making a distinction, but others save their fear, pulling them out of the fire, hating even the garment defiled by the flesh. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling, and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory, with exceeding joy to God our Savior, who alone is wise, give glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. Do not love the world, nor things which are in the world. The world shall pass away and all its desires. Be you, does the will of God, shall abide forever. Amen.
Yeah.
the apostles, the holy blessed, be with us all, amen. But I might an angel of the Lord opened the prison doors and brought him out and said, Go stand in the temple and speak to the people all the words of this life. And when they heard that, they entered the temple early in the morning and taught. But the high priest and those with him came and called the council together with all the elders of the children of Israel and sent to the prison to have them brought. But when the officers came and did not find them in the prison, they returned and reported, saying, Indeed, we found the prison shut securely, and the guards standing outside before the doors. But when we opened them, we found no one inside. Now when the high priest, the captain of the temple, and the chief priests heard these things, they wondered what the outcome would be. Then one came and told them, saying, Look, the men whom you put in prison are standing in the temple and teaching the people. And the captain went with the officers and brought them without violence, for they feared the people, lest they should be stoned. And when they had brought them, they set them before the council. And the high priest asked them, saying, Did we not strictly command you not to teach in this name? Then look, you have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine, and intend to bring this man's blood on us. Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, We ought to obey God rather than men. The word of the Lord shall grow and multiply, be mighty and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
من شهر أكتوبر المبارك أحسن الله استقبال واستقبال إنسان إنساني ونحن في دون ربنا من كفر الخطايا والزلات من كفر المرحمة رب يا باكتي أمين.
On this day the great Saint Martin, Bishop of Tours, departed. He was born to Christian parents in a city called Sorpia. He grew up to be gentle and a worshiper who kept the Orthodox faith. He did not spare any effort in resisting the followers of Arius, who were enraged by him. Consequently, they waited for him on a road several times and beat him. When they continued chasing him, he left the city. He went to live in a cave near the shore of the Mediterranean Sea. There he sustained himself by eating plants. When his reputation spread throughout the country, he was chosen to be Bishop of Tours. He lived an apostolic life and grew in charity and mercy towards many people. The Lord performed many miracles through him. Once, when he was passing by, he saw a person stopping a funeral and preventing the deceased person's family from burying him, claiming that the deceased owed him 400 dinars. This holy father entreated him to release the dead body, but the man refused. Saint Martin prayed and entreated God to make the truth known. The dead man was raised immediately, and he rebuked the man who falsely accused him, exposing his lies before those present. Subsequently, the unjust man died, and the man who was raised from death through the prayers of St. Martin went back to his home and lived many years. This Holy Father completed his distinguished life and departed in peace. His prayers be with us, and glory to our God forever and ever.
Agios o Theos, Agios Echeros, Agios Asanatos, o Evangelion Genetis Eleison Imes, Agios o Theos, Agios Echeros, Agios Asanatos, o Sanatos, Christos Theonas.
المقدسين ورسل الأطهار المكرمين قائلا إنا بأبرار كثيرين اشتموا أن يروا ما أنتم ترون ولم يروا وليسمعوا ما أنتم تسمعون ولم يسمعوا أما أنتم فاتوب على أعينكم لأن أعطوهم لأن تسمع فنستحق أن نسمع ونعمل بأناجيلك المقدسة بيت القديس
صوم أبدي المقدس
أشكر أيضا يا سيدنا كل الذين أمروهم وأوصلنا أن نشكرهم في سؤالاتنا وطلباتنا التي نصيبها إليك أيها الرب إلهنا الذين سبق رضاهم يا رب ليحكم أن مرضى اشفيهم لأنك أنت وحياتنا كلنا خلاصنا كلنا شفاؤنا كلنا رجاؤنا كلنا وقيامتنا كلنا
أمين يا مروج أسبتك سيادة
Yeah. the name of the Lord, our Lord God and Savior and King of us all, Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, the world is born glory. Together to him, so that he got in the boat and sat, and the whole multitude stood on the shore. Then he spoke many things to them in parables, saying, behold, the sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell by the wayside, and the birds came and devoured them. Some fell on stony places where they did not have much earth, and they immediately sprang up because they had no depth of earth. But when the sun was up and they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. And some fell among the thorns, and the thorns sprang up and choked them. But others fell on good ground and yielded a crop, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. He was used to hear, let him hear.
Glory be to God's glory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen.
Today's Gospel, the parable of the sower, the Lord Jesus Christ, illustrated with this parable different type of people, four different type of people. As you heard in the Gospel, we're going to talk about how people react to the Word of God. First type, we're going to call him Mr. Stubborn. Alright? He represents the persons who reject the Word of God, reject to believe in His existence, reject His Bible, reject His holy commandments. They refuse to listen, willingly blocking their ears and blinding their eyes. They do not want to listen, exactly as the Lord said in the book of Matthew chapter 13, for the hearts of this people have grown dull, their ears are hard of hearing, and their eyes they have closed, lest they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears, lest they should understand with their heart and turn, so that I should heal them. So those people have ears and eyes like everyone else, but they, by their choice, they refuse. That's why the Lord used to say, he who has ears, let him hear. It's a matter of choice. But those people, Mr. Stubborn, people reject and refuse to listen. We can conclude with this type, the people who know the commandments of God, but they refuse to do it. For example, the Bible teaches to love your neighbor as yourself, but they do not want to love. The Bible teaches to forgive one another, but they refuse to forgive. forgive me trespasses. But the problem is, we pray every day and say, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, but we do not forgive, and we need God to forgive us. Example of this, Mr. Stubborn was Pharaoh in the Old Testament in the story of Moses. He rejected to let the people of God to go and worship, in spite of all the plagues, all the miracles, and all what God has inflicted on the Egyptians. And this is a very bad type of soil or type of people. The second type of the soil, which God said there is a small thin layer of dirt on the top, and underneath there is rocks, and those people are, we can call them Mr. Hypocrites. Mr. Hypocrite. He's not better than the first type, by the way. Matter of fact, if you think about it a little bit, you will find out that those people may be even worse than the first type. I'm going to tell you why. Because those people hide themselves behind a veil of hypocrisy. As I said, some dirt on the top, icing on the cake, outside looks okay, but inside is really bad. These poor people, not only they deceive themselves, but also, not only they deceive others, but also they deceive themselves. Because they think of themselves better than others. As the Pharisee, even in his prayer to God, he was not embarrassed to stand in front of God to brag about himself and how good he was. And he did not stop here, but also he condemned the other person and said that he is bad. Not only the tax collector, but everyone else. He said, God, I thank you that I am not like other men. All the other people are bad and he's the only one is good. Extortioners, unjust, adulterers, or even as this tax collector. I fast twice a week and give tithes of all that I possess. Such people will never change because they think that they are good and there is no need to change. They are happy that way. They are satisfied. They are comfortable. So they do not see any reason for the change. This type is whom the Lord Jesus meant when he reproached the scribes and Pharisees in Matthew 23, when he said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you are like whitewashed tombs, which indeed appear beautiful outwardly, but inside are full of dead men's bones and all uncleanness. Even so, you also outwardly appear righteous to men, but inside you are full of hypocrisy and lawlessness." Mr. Hypocrite. I think this type is much worse than the first one. At least the first one is known and exposed, and everyone knows that he's stubborn and he rejects the word of God out plainly. But this type here, he looks like a very good man, righteous man, but indeed is from inside full of wickedness. Third type, which the Lord has said, the seeds was thrown among thorns. And we can signify that this type, you can call him Mr. Busy Man. Mr. Busy Man. Being busy is not a sin in itself, but it occupies the heart and the mind of the people and does not leave room for God. And this is also very dangerous because it is somehow deceiving. God said, love your God from all your heart. But those people are too busy to think about Him. They are too busy about their own salvation. They do not have time for God, no time for prayers, no time for reading Bible, no time for church, no time for communion. God is not in the list, or if he is in the very bottom of the list. Always thinking on how to multiply their business, how to get more busier, how to enlarge their territory, and there's no limit. There is no limit. And as long as they do not do something wrong, it is deceiving, because the devil wants you to be busy. You don't have time to confess, you don't have time to repent, you don't have time to even to practice how to be a good person. He does not realize that the love of money and the cares of the world are the motive behind all his work. Business and 2 and 3 and 4 and 10 wanted to multiply. Hidden reason inside, the love of money, the love of authority, the love of possessions, the love of the world and its desires. I have $1 million, but I want them to make to be 2, and I want them to be 3 and 5, and why not? And we can put some names to this as a success. And I have goals, and I'm eager to improve and to be a successful person. But believe me, this takes all your thoughts, all your energy, all your heart. And the Lord has said, wherever your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Such people don't have any time to think about God or to think about heaven. Listen to the parable of the king's feast in St. Luke chapter 14, where the Lord said, the king made a feast, and then he started inviting people to attend. But they all, with one accord, began to make excuses. All began to make excuses. We're going to go through those excuses, and we're going to find them real reasons, good reasons, acceptable reasons, but we'll see what's the reaction of the king what happened. The first said to him, I have bought a piece of ground and I must go and see it. I ask you to have me excused. Another said, I have bought 5 yoke of oxen and I'm going to test them. I ask you to have me excused. Still another said, I have married a wife and therefore I cannot come. Seems all these reasons are good reasons, and we all use those reasons every day. But still, the Bible mentioned that the master of the house, being angry, so those excuses did not please him, was not acceptable to him. He became angry, and he said, I say to you that none of those men who were invited shall taste my supper. What do you think about this? You waste all your life running after money and possessions and business, and then finally you hear, go away, I do not know you, you have no chance to eat my supper. This will be where the Bible said, gnashing of teeth, weeping and gnashing of teeth. Good example from the Bible, the young rich man who went away grieving, for he had great possessions. He was a good man. He kept the commandments since his youth. He was searching and looking for his eternity. He wanted to inherit eternal life. But he had great possessions. He went away grieving. The other example also in the Bible, the rich man, the unwise rich man, whose riches occupied his mind and his thinking. The Lord told him, "Fool, this night your soul will be required of you." Then whose will those things be which you have provided? What you have provided, who's going to take all this? You labored for nothing. You labored for vain. I remember a story. A man was very rich and told his wife, "I need you when I go, when I die. Put all my gold and silver and all my possessions in my coffin. I will take them with me." Sure enough, on the day of the funeral, they found his wife bringing a box, and she said, "I want this to be in the coffin with him." The people started mocking her and saying, "Are you going to put all these possessions, all this money, all this gold in with him?" She said, "No, I put it in the bank and I wrote him a check. And he's able to cash it, he's welcome to." And this is what we're doing. We're going to put everything here and we're not going to take with us anything. That's why the church insists in repeating to us every day, do not love the world or the things in the world. The world passes away and its desires, but he who does the will of God abides forever. Mr. Stubborn, Mr. Hypocrite, and Mr. Busy Man. All three types, sadly, they did not provide fruits. The fourth type is Mr. Wise Man. Mr. Wise Man. He represents the spiritual people who is worried about their own salvation. This is their own priority, the first priority on their list. The Holy Bible gives us description, and I pray that this description applies on all of us. Think about the Bible said about the righteous man and give us example about Zechariah and Elizabeth. He said, they walked in all the commandments of God blameless. All the commandments of God blameless. So everyone measured himself on this verse. Are we walking in all the commandments of God blameless? Also, Psalm number 1 gives us description for the righteous man, the wise man. He who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. Also, David, the prophet, gave us another description in Psalm 14. Psalm 14, if you keep it in mind, very helpful. The righteous person who's going to have a place in heaven with God, description, he who walks uprightly and works righteousness, speaks the truth in his heart, very important, speaks the truth in his heart. He who does not backbite with his tongue, nor does evil to his neighbor, nor does he take up a reproach against his friend, in whose eyes a vile person is despised, but he honors those who fear the Lord. He who swears to his own hurt and does not change, he who does not put out his money at usury, nor does he take a bribe against the innocent, he who does these things shall never be moved. He who renders to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's. He has distinction or discern what comes first. He obeys and follows the words of God. He who keeps himself unspotted from the world. St. James chapter 1. Finally, he is the humble person, not stubborn, not hypocrite, not busy with the world cares and money, and his heart and his treasure is in heaven. Glory be to God forever. Amen.
بطريرك الأنطاك مرة ما تزكى بطريرك
Patriarca Antakya, Abuna Antonos, Patriarca Eritrea, Abuna Philopos, Patriarca Ethiopia, Washariko, Fatima Tresulia, Adinina Oskomo, Karon, and Ayusi.
Pray for our honored father, the high priest, Baba Tadros II, Patriarch and Archbishop of the great city of Alexandria, and his spiritual brothers, Maria Vlantis of Ram II Karim, the Ethiopian Patriarch of Olympias, the first Ethiopian Patriarch, and Abuna Antonius, the first Eritrean Patriarch, and his partner in the apostolic service, our honored father, our bishop, Abba Yosef, and our orthodox bishop.
Thanks be unto God. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father, before all ages, Son of God, true God, true God, begotten not created, of one is the Father, and all things are made, who for us and for our salvation came down from heaven. Virgin Mary became man, and this is Father, blessed and blessed Father, something was buried, and the third day rose from the dead, according to the scriptures, and ascended to the heavens. He says, our aim is Father, and he's coming again, as the Lord judge the living dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. Yes, we give the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who receives from the Father, the Son, worship, and glorified, who spoke by the prophets, the Holy God, and so our church.
We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of his new Church
Grandly, the ability to chant and use good understanding, so they will chant you from the depth of their hearts in the spirit of prayer and worship. Grant that they may serve you with all their hearts by filling their mouths with the hymns. Accept their chest, sweet savor before you. Remove from them the spirit of pride, assurance, and boasting. Make them good servants by the grace, compassion, and love of mankind, your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Savior Jesus Christ, we ask and entreat your goodness for the love of mankind, for these your servants who are standing before you, who came to your Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church, shine upon them with the sweetness of your holy words, grant them to chant with understanding spiritual praises, may they become worthy to begin with faithfulness, and worship you with understanding and purity, sanctify them, bless them, fill them with your fear, guard them with your angelic power, enrich them with every good gift and perfect talent, so that they may live according to your holy and pure will, that is pleasing unto you, and be called the most perfect and better growth of your Holy Spirit, by your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. Santus in the Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amen. Chemifran, Imifiot, Imifshirin, and Bernuf, Maif, Oer, or Monti, and Omot, if it's Mara, Odi, J, if not, if you'll be Batokra, Dor, Mara, Odi, J, if Mono, Genis, and Shir, is Os, the Christos, Ben Shoiz, if it's Mara, Odi, J, if not, Maif, Oer, El Paraclito. The Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amin, Chalifan, Imviot, Imavshir, and Abudnav, Raith, Oer, Onot, Yer, Oot, Vizmara, Odin, Jef, Not, If, Yot, Ivan, Tukra, Dua, Vizmara, Odin, Jef, Fon, Genis, and Shiri, Isos, Ve, Christos, Ven, Shoiz, Vizmara, Odin, Jef, Ibnav, Maith, Oer, El, Paraklito. Santus in the Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amin, Chalifan, Imviot, Imavshiri, Never, never, I thought, or not, if I want to smile, or did you, if not, if your people took her to smile, or did you perform against her? She is also a Christmas and choice. Smile, or did you be a bit nice over and paraclito? Joseph of Santos in the Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amin, Chalifan, Imviot, Imavshiri. Never does my forward, or not if my own, if it's my old, if not if you'd be one to gratuit. If it's my old, if my own, and he said, Cheer, he's was the Christmas bad choice. If it's my old, if my forward, and paraclito. Just then, if Saltus in the Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amin, Chalifan, if you'd be Shiri. Never do my forward, or not if my own, if it's my old, if not if you'd be one to gratuit. Smara Odin Jeb, if Mono Genis and Shiri is Os, Be Christos, Ben Shoiz. Smara Odin Jeb, if Nif Maif Kuhar, Em Paraklito. After Asis of Saltus in the Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amin, Terefani, if you're the Rashiri, never Nif Maif Kuhar, or not if my own, if it's my Odin Jeb, if not if you'd be one to gratuit. Smara Odin Jeb, if Mono Genis and Shiri is Os, Be Christos, Ben Shoiz. Smara Odin Jeb, if Nif Maif Kuhar, Em Paraklito. If Saltus in the Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amin, Chalifan, if you're the Rashiri, never been five over, or not if my own, if it's my own, if not if you'd be one to gratuit, it's my own, and Jeb, if one of your niece and cheery is all spare Christmas, not choice, it's my own, and Jeb, if not five over, and Paraclito. If Saltus in the Holy Orthodox Church of God, Amin, Chalifan, if you're the Rashiri, never been five over, or not if my own, if it's my own, if not if you'd be one to gratuit. It's my own, if you'd be Gemeinschaft hier Jesus der Christus ganz schön. Das war der Oden Chibi in der Freispule im Paraklito.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. And Lord, Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, hear us and have mercy upon us. Offer, offer, offer in order, stand with trembling. Lord, for say, set us aside. Paradise of joy.
when we disobeyed your commandment by the deceit of the serpent, we fell from eternal life and were exiled from the paradise of joy. You have not abandoned us to thee, but have always visited us through your holy prophets. And in the last days, you manifested yourself to us while sitting in darkness and the shadow of death. Through your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, of the Holy Spirit and of the Holy Virgin Mary. Salvation. He granted us the birth from on high through water and His Spirit. He made us unto Himself an assembled people and sanctified us by your Holy Spirit. He loved His own who were in the world, and as a ransom on our behalf, gave Himself up unto death with children over us, whereby we were bound and sold on account of our sins. He descended into Hades through the cross. Sat at your right hand, O Father. He has appointed a day for recompense on which He will appear to judge the world in righteousness and give each one according to His deeds.
According to your mercy,
for us this great mystery of darkness, for being determined to give Himself up to death for the life of the blessed are life giving.
We believe that this is true. Amen.
He looked up towards heaven to you, O God, who are His Father and Master of everyone. And when He had given thanks,
Amen.
He angels and holy apostles sing. Take eat of it, all of you, for this is my body, which is broken for you and for many to be given for the remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is true. Amen.
Likewise, also the cup after supper, he mixed it of wine and water, and when he had given thanks, on saintly disciples and holy apostles saying, take the drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many to be given for the remission of sins. This do in remembrance of this cup, you proclaim my death, confess my resurrection, and remember me till I come.
Amen, amen, amen. Your death, O Lord, we proclaim your holy
into the heavens, he's sitting at your right hand, oh Father, and his second coming from the heavens, awesome and full of glory, we offer unto you your gifts from what is yours for everything, concerning everything, and in every
we worship you.
Thy Christ, our God,
and bless them to grow and multiply into perfection with great fruit. Have compassion on this creation which is hands unmade, and forgive us our sins.
Abundantly watered, and its fruits be plentiful. Prepare it for sowing and harvesting, marriage online as deem fair. Bless the crown of the year with your goodness, for the sake of the poor of your people, for the widow, the orphan, the traveler, the stranger, and for the sake of all of us who entreat you and seek your holy name. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food in due season. Deal with us according to your goodness, O you who give food to all flesh. Fill our hearts with joy and gladness, that we too, having sufficiency in everything, always may abound in every good deed.
Remember, O Lord, those who have brought you these gifts, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought, give them all the heavenly gifts, our sacrifices, and those who bring them.
Lord, have mercy.
Hey.
Generation to generation.
us in this, so also in all things, your great and holy name may be glorified, blessed, and exalted in everything, honored and blessed, with Jesus Christ, your beloved Son, and the Holy Spirit, peace be with all.
And with your Lord's spirit.
And again, let us give thanks to God, the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, for he also has made us worthy now to stand in this holy place, to lift up our hands and to serve his holy name. Let us also ask him to make us worthy of the communion and partaking of his divine and immortal mystery.
Passes.
He confessed a good confession before Pontius Pilate. He gave it up for us upon the holy wood of the cross of his own work for us all. Truly I believe that his divinity parted not from his humanity for a single moment nor a twinkling of an eye, given for us for salvation, remission of sins, and eternal life to those who partake of him. I believe. That this is true.
Amen.
I believe that this is true. Amen. Pray for us and for all Christians who said to us concerning them, remember us in the house of the Lord, the peace and love of Jesus Christ be with you. Sing hallelujah. Pray for the worthy partaking of the Immaculate Heavenly and Holy Mysteries, Lord, have mercy.
Thank you. Yeah. Give us the power. Thank you.
For the baptized children and also for the newly ordained deacons.